Hola mis panas y bienvenidos a mi canal Made by Roots Venezuela. Hoy tenemos una invitada súper especial, demos la bienvenida a Mika.
¡Hola!
Ok, esta sección la voy a llamar Un Café con Anderson. ¿Por qué Un Café con Anderson? Porque mientras estamos tomando un café, estaremos hablando sobre anécdotas que nos han pasado aquí en Alemania, o situaciones, o dudas, o muchas incertidumbres que las personas tienen acerca de nosotros en nuestra vida aquí en Alemania como inmigrantes. Así que sin más nada que decir, ¡comencemos! First impression in the first day at school?
Well, when I went to the language school, I had not been out of my house. I had just moved here. I was 3 weeks here and I had not met anybody because I only knew two words, bread and tiny matchbox. Not helpful. So I was so desperate to make friends and connect with people that honestly learning the language was like second thing. But the good thing is, once I got there, I realized we were all in the same position. We were all trying to learn this language that scared us so much. And so I was glad to just get started on learning how to do it.
Yeah, that actually is true. I would agree with that because actually my first day was a little bit like this and I was a little bit like, I mean, I would like to know, get to know people as well, but at the same time, I want to be really focused on it because I know how important and how difficult it was. And I was trying to get through that. That's true. What was the most difficult part of learning German?
In the beginning, I don't know if it was like this for you, but for me, it was definitely the pronunciation. Because I was looking at these words, and they're super long, famously super long. And you look at the word, and it looks like 16 letters all together that don't go together, and you have no idea how to say them. And so I would look at these things, and it just looked like absolute madness on the page. And you have to, in German, you pronounce every single letter, and that's how you pronounce it. But these are letters that don't go together. So I'd be out there saying things that didn't make any sense, and that was supposed to be a word. So that for me was the hardest in the beginning.
I would agree as well with that. But at the same time, I would say like the most difficult part for me was like to learn how to pronounce the R like they all the time pronounce.
Oh my gosh.
Because for example, okay, I got used already to pronounce this R from English, like R, which is our R in Spanish. But at the same time, I was like, how can I do like R, R? And I spent 3 months literally like trying to learn that shit. Sorry. To learn that. And it was so difficult. And I said like, oh my God, it really feels sick. But finally I did it.
It feels super wrong.
Yeah, exactly. Do you have a special situation that is really was really embarrassing or really funny that you can tell us?
This happens to me all the time. I make mistakes with words, false friends, things that sound similar in English or even that sound similar in German. But the most absolute embarrassing one just happened to me recently, and it was one of those days where I was feeling super confident about my German and I was talking to someone about this like deep conversation. We were talking about guns and she's like weapons and she was like, oh yeah, it's a huge problem. My mom's really struggling with it. She's got guns all over the place and her farm, she lives in a farm and they're huge and it's super dangerous. And I was like, oh my gosh, you had to call the police. Like the police have to come and take the guns. And she's like, why would they do that? They're too busy, that's stupid. Like, don't worry about it. The problem is they're really dangerous. I'm like, yeah, they're really dangerous. She's like, yeah, because they're so big and they're loud. I'm like, yeah, they're super loud, that's true. And I'm like, you really should call the police. This is really a problematic. And I'm thinking, man, I'm doing great. I'm speaking about deep conversations about German things and all that.
I'm good as hell.
And I'm like, I'm good as hell. This is going well. She's like, suddenly we had this moment where you look at her and she looks at me and she's like, wait, what are you talking about? I'm like, well, guns. You're saying that your mom has guns all over her property. She said, no, guns. Guns, like honk honk. Geese. It's the word for geese. She was talking about birds and I was talking about like weapons. So embarrassing. I was like, I have to walk out of the situation and never ever speak to another person again.
Well, it has happened to me several times that you feel that someone is insulting you and then actually they really doing compliments because actually German is like, when they compliments you or like give you compliments to you, you feels like they are doing like a twisty way, like they do like, oh, this coffee doesn't taste bad. I mean, say like, well, that means it's not good enough. But actually it's the opposite way. They tell you like it tastes really good. So that's the problem. Like, sometimes they really try to do something and you feel like they're doing the opposite way and you feel offended, but actually it's not like this.
Right.
It really happened to me several times and I feel like so embarrassed because I think it's like the whole opposite way. But anyway,
it's a lot of misunderstandings, like, I think. There's a lot of, you have different cultural backgrounds, different language backgrounds. It's so easy to misunderstand each other.
Yeah, it's like a learning by doing, I would say.
Exactly.
Especially like this. Another question for you. What's your favorite word in German?
My favorite German word is Verdauungsspaziergang.
Wow.
What I love about it is exactly to me the epitome of perfect German. What German is so great at. And what it really literally translates to is a casual stroll or walk to help you digest something. That's it, that's this huge thing. And what I love about it is, of course, so German to have one word that explains this huge kind of concept thing. So instead of having to say, hey, let's go take a walk casually to help us digest the food that we've eaten because it was too much for us, instead, you say, komm, wir machen einen Verdauungsspaziergang.
So you use just only several words and then you describe everything you just did in English or Spanish that you have to,
exactly.
Like, it's literally a text to say that word.
Exactly.
We don't have that such a word. I mean, we don't need that because we don't, after eat, we don't walk. We just stay there and just chat and stuff like that, but yeah, it makes sense, actually.
Exactly.
And what is your least favorite?
Oh gosh, I think I have tons of words that are too hard to say. It's really anytime I hit a word that I can't pronounce as well, then I'm like, this is my new least favorite word. And then I think about that word forever. But obviously now I can't even think of one because I have so many of those words that I've hit in a sentence and the whole sentence has just fallen apart because I can't pronounce it. So anything with that like, I mean, English doesn't have any sounds like that with that O umlaut that's like or E, any of that stuff, I can't. Honestly, I think my least favorite thing is though, I cannot spell out loud in German.
Oh.
I cannot do it. So anytime I have to spell my name, nightmare. I'd rather say words I can't pronounce than have to spell with letters. Thinking of learning German, I can't recommend it enough. The language is one of the most surprising, poetic, and precise languages you could ever learn. You will learn so much about yourself and how to communicate by learning German. So take the time, it's totally worth it. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe below.
Bueno, mis panas, este fue el video de hoy. Si te gustó el video, si te pareció informativo, si te divertiste, no olvides darle like, comentarlo, suscribirte a este canal, publicarlo, repostearlo. Y bueno, más nada, o sea, bienvenidos a la sección Un Café con Anderson, Made by Roots Venezuela. Hasta la próxima y chao. Bueno, me voy a hacer otra taza de café porque este café está frío, chicos.